I do good?
Yeah, great. Yeah.
How about you do
flawless.
This? You do this whole thing in American.
You do this whole thing in American.
Why are we all from the South?
Why are we all from Limerick?
I don't know.
Am I right?
Am I right?
Am I right, yeah. I'm right there, yeah.
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 Let's do it.
Yeah.
That way
are we rolling, are we? Mm. Are you going to include a bit of this nonsense as well?
No,
you know, yeah. So that is a tendency to, like, all this nonsense beforehand, this ends up making the cut.
That is the cut. That is the cut.
Every time.
To me, that's, yeah. It's the B-sides, man. It's the good stuff. Deep cuts. Deep cuts going deep cuts. Way back.
Fresh but deep.
Mm. Hey, you want a little tip? Look down. Close your eyes.
Okay.
And I'm going to say fresh eyes in 3, 2, 1, and then you open with fresh eyes. 3, 2, 1. Fresh eyes.
Fresh eyes.
And just look at the camera.
I'm there already.
Are we on that camera?
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Good stuff.
All right.
So, hi guys. Welcome back to 21 Drums here in Grouse Lodge. Another interview. This one with the irrepressible Mike Johnston.
I don't know what that word means, but I like it.
Yeah, it's a good word.
It's huge.
So, first question, Mike. Tell us, what makes 21 Drums so special?
You. That's probably the big thing. If you haven't been around this gent... The underarms smell like breezy ocean tides at dusk. It's just beautiful.
It's quite wonderful.
I could almost eat your scent. Yeah. Other than that, what makes it special is just the people that are here, obviously. Center yourself. Yeah, yeah. The people that are here are amazing. The students come from all around the world. The teachers that are here, I think what's special about it is that we're so different stylistically, and more importantly, we're so different in approach, but yet we, all three of us, ended up in our dream scenarios. And that's what I find really inspiring is when I talk to Ash about how he got his hands to where they are, it's nothing like the approach I took, and it's nothing like Mark's approach, but yet we still all got to the same place. So I think it's the arrival at your dream, but seeing all these different paths to get there, so it allows the students to have the freedom to say, hey, there is no one way to get anywhere. It's really just finding a desired result, and that becomes the technique. It's a desired result technique. Find the end, and then just work your butt off and keep your head down until you get there. And then when you get there, then you can look up and ask yourself, what did it take for me to get here? So I find the drummers that are here, and then the other thing is that the fact that some of the drummers that are attending this camp are professional drummers. So we're just as inspired from them as maybe they are from us. So
beautiful. I don't think you noticed, but you're slipping into a little bit of the Limerick thing again. It's just kind of dropping in here and there. No, it's great. I can't help it.
There's accents everywhere around me.
Yeah, it's abundant.
So you need me to get like super American.
Yeah,
would that
course.
Be okay? All right.
Yeah. Let's move on to your gear. Your
shan't
beautiful,
we?
Beautiful. We shan't. No, we shall.
No, we shall.
Shall. We shall. Shan't we? We shall. Yeah, and that's the end. That's the end of the interview there. Let's start with your wonderful setup of cymbals here. You've got these gorgeous Meinls in front of us.
Yeah.
Can you talk me through your selections?
Absolutely. So 15-inch Byzance dual hats. So these are extremely buttery and soft sounding. One, because they're 15 inches, but also because they're pretty thin. So I love those, but they still have a really good chick with the foot. I've got a 22-inch Big Apple Dark Ride. I've only been playing this for maybe 3 or 4 months. I got into a new musical project that needed a more buttery ride than my transition ride. So I thought, well, let's just go with a two ride setup. I also really like the crash on it. It's super dark and extremely fast decay, just boosh, and it's gone. So I've got that. And then when I need my ride to cut through a little bit more and I need a little bell action, that's when I go with the 21-inch transition ride. You can get good stick definition out of it, but you can also bash on it a little bit. So it can be a 21-inch crash if I really want to get loud. And then if I just need an actual crash cymbal on my kit, that's where I've got the 19-inch extra dry thin crash. Yeah, that thing just looks like dragon scales.
Mm.
Watch out, Khaleesi, coming for you.
Beautiful. Let's move on to your beautiful. I've used the word beautiful twice in succession there.
Your lexicon of adjectives. Let's go with gorgeous.
Yeah. Let's move on to this excellent drum kit in front of us.
Nice.
So you're playing a Gretsch Brooklyn here.
I am indeed. So the Brooklyn, out of the three U.S. lines, you've got USA Custom, Broadcaster, and Brooklyn. The Brooklyn is probably my favorite. I play a Broadcaster at home and a Brooklyn, but the Brooklyn has something, there's something different about, it's a 6-ply shell, and you've got maple, then 4 plies of poplar, and then maple. There's something about that poplar in the middle it gives it almost like a trampoline effect. Like you play the drums, but they come out at you and your sticks kind of fly off the drums no matter what the tuning. So I really, really enjoy the Brooklyns. They're probably my favorite in the lineup. And I also like, since I'm a teacher, I like for my students that they're also affordable. But yeah, so it's Brooklyn all around. I've got a Brooklyn wood snare here, and then a Brooklyn 14x5.5 chrome over brass snare here. And this one I've just got detuned to do, and then this one is skplank.
Skplank.
So I've got, you know, ting, skplank, skplank, get to displink. That's it.
Nice.
You want to sing for me?
No.
Yeah, you should.
Aquarian drumheads, Mike.
Still, after still, all these years.
After all these years,
I signed with Aquarian when I was 21, and I'm 40 now. So 19 years of Aquarian drumheads. And it has changed, though. I've switched to texture-coated, which is single-ply. Texture-coated single-ply on top and bottom. So that's new for me. That's only been maybe 4 months. I was telling my rep at Aquarian that I'd been playing a lot softer, so I didn't really need the durability of two-ply heads. And I said I just wanted more attack, but I didn't want to go all the way to switching to clear heads. And so he suggested the single-ply texture-coated. And then I told him at first, I said, I've never played single-plies. There's so much tone. They're so ringy. And he said, just put texture-coated on the bottom, too, and that'll really help that out. So it warmed up the drums a lot. So really, on this whole kit, besides, obviously, the bottom of the snares, I've got the same heads top and bottom. And then on the kick, I'm using Force 1. So that's a single-ply head, and then it's got a little reinforcement ring around it.
Sure. Yeah. Beautiful. Your sticks, you have two sets of sticks. You have both a hickory and a maple pair.
I'm an only child. I'm fairly selfish.
Cool. Yeah. So what was the thinking behind having the two different sticks?
At the time, I only played maple sticks. When we developed this stick with Vader, I only played maple sticks. And I was scared to release the stick in maple because a lot of people aren't familiar with it. And if they were trying to maybe support me and they ordered the sticks, but they hit really hard, those are going to snap on you. And then they would blame me or Vader. And it's like, it's just the wood you chose. So I asked Vader, can we also put this stick out in hickory since it's filling a gap in your lineup that of size? You don't have this anyways. And so they agreed to release it in both hickory and maple. And honestly, I would say every 3 months I switch from one to the other.
Right.
But one thing that Mark and I were testing out yesterday is how much difference hickory makes and maple makes on a cymbal. And so he was saying that on one of his rides, he loved the maple. And then on the other ride, he really loved the hickory. And we could really hear how it changed things from stick to stick. So it was pretty cool.
Awesome. Awesome. And I believe, finally, you play DW Hardware.
DW Hardware, yeah. So I've been with them since I was 21 as well. And I really mean this. I just don't think there's anything equal to it. It's amazing. It's never let me down. I'm not overly punishing on my hardware anymore like I was in my youth. But the thing is, as a teacher and as a person that hosts a lot of drum camps, I'm not the only one that plays my kit. So there's generally myself and 8 other people playing my kit for a week at a time, 10 times per summer, and nothing's ever broken down. And that's really cool. Yeah, so I love the hardware. This is just the dream setup for me. I mean, I'm very lucky to be able to play all the gear that I would go out and buy if I was starting to play drums now and had an endless budget. So
beautiful. That's the lot, pretty much, isn't
right?
it?
Right? Yeah.
Wasn't that awkward?
No. I mean, just your legs.
Yeah.
Good God.
You're getting in the way a bit.
Do you not have sun here?
No. Sorry.
You, just so you know, for everyone at home, Oisín is my 47th favorite Irish drummer. So I'm just messing with him. I mean, he's really up there for me. Top 47, without a doubt.
That's everything. Tear. Thanks, guys. See you again.
Well done. Good job.
Thanks, mate. Likewise, buddy.
Thank you so much.